Hi, everyone. My name is Amit Kadan. I'm an ML engineer here at SandboxAQ working on the AI sim team. And specifically, I focus on research and development of our generative AI capabilities. And today, I'll be talking about our work on guided multi-objective generative AI to enhance structure-based drug design, which is research that we took on in order to develop a tool that was able to generate small molecules for target protein pockets. Traditionally, the way that small molecules are designed for a target protein is by iterating over a large chemical database and trying to find molecules that will have desired physicochemical properties, such as synthetic accessibility, solubility, but also affinity with the protein that you're trying to target. However, this is also very time-consuming because these chemical libraries can be quite large, often spanning billions of molecules. So it's extremely computationally exhaustive to go through the entire library and evaluate properties for each of these molecules. This presents a huge opportunity for generative AI, where a generative AI algorithm can be seeded with information from the target protein in order to design molecules that are particular to that protein target without having to iterate over some large chemical space. Essentially, the generative AI jumps right to the pertinent part of chemical space in order to generate a molecule for the target of interest. However, even in a scheme where a generative AI model is generating a molecule directly into the pocket, there are a bunch of other physicochemical properties that we may be interested in. For instance, how easy is this molecule to synthesize in a lab? Or how toxic is this molecule going to be? And you're not going to necessarily get that information by the context of the protein pocket. So we want to have some other methodology for enforcing these additional physicochemical constraints into our generative process. So in this work, we present IDOLpro, which is inverse design of optimal ligands for protein pockets. So IDOLpro is an LQM technology, which combines aspects of cutting-edge AI and physics in harmony in order to create a workflow that is able to produce outputs that are useful for drug discovery in the real world. In IDOLpro, we have a diffusion model, which is state-of-the-art at generating molecules tailored to a specific protein pocket, being guided by two different differentiable scores. One of these differentiable scores is a machine learning model that has been trained to predict the synthetic accessibility of molecules. The other scoring function in IDOLpro is actually a torch-based implementation of a commonly used physics-based score known as the Venus score. And the Venus score is used widely in order to perform docking and in order to evaluate binding affinity efficiently and quickly. What we did was we took this physics-based score, we re-implemented it in PyTorch, and then we were able to actually get gradients directly with respect to the score in order to guide the diffusion model. The way this works is that we roll out the diffusion up to some optimization horizon. We freeze the latent vectors at that point in the diffusion process. Then we roll out the rest of the diffusion process, generate a novel ligand. We evaluate that ligand with respect to the set of differentiable scores. And then we take the gradient of these scores with respect to the latent vector at the time horizon and take a step in the latent space. Therefore, next time we roll out the rest of the diffusion process, we're going to get a ligand with slightly better binding affinity and synthetic accessibility. And we iterate this process over and over again to produce ligands that have both of these properties optimized. A novelty of this sort of framework, as opposed to some of the other guided diffusion frameworks, such as classifier guidance, is that it's highly modular. In classifier guidance, because we need to add a gradient term from a classifier at each step in the diffusion process, we actually need to train an ad hoc classifier that can take in intermediate noisy samples particular to the diffusion model of interest in order to guide that model towards generating samples with optimized properties. However, in IDOLpro, we can take any of the scores that we know how to apply to 3D molecules and directly feed them into the pipeline in order to optimize the latent vectors of the generative model. On top of that, the generative model itself can be replaced with any other generative model able to produce 3D molecular coordinates. as I mentioned, IDOLpro is this workflow for taking a generative model that is already tailored to perform the task of producing molecules for a target protein, but then using additional differentiable scores in order to get highly optimized outputs from that same generative model. In this figure, we can actually see the power of this sort of framework. And what we've pictured is some data points from the data set that we were using to evaluate our platform. This is the cross-dock data set. In the left panel, we have the reference ligands from this data set. And we can see that these ligands are, you know, they have quite good binding affinities and are relatively synthetically accessible. Next, we have the raw outputs of the generative model. And just based on the figure alone, we can see that these molecules, despite having decent binding affinities, are not something that any medicinal chemist is going to be happy with. Once we apply the IDOLpro framework, which both optimizes binding affinity and synthetic accessibility, the molecules look much better. They have much better properties in terms of both synthetic accessibility and binding affinity, and also look much more like the reference ligands. So all good signs that indeed plugging a generative model into this workflow is doing exactly what we want it to do. So we evaluated IDOLpro on two standard benchmarks in the literature. One experimental data set called the cross-dock data set, which consists of ligands that are docked to proteins via computational approach. On top of that, we also evaluated IDOLpro on an experimental data set of protein ligand complexes called the binding MOAD. For each of these data sets, we took the target proteins and the ligand, which is used to define the pocket within the protein, and we tested the performance of IDOLpro versus a host of other deep learning generative models in the literature. We found that IDOLpro consistently outperforms all the other generative models in terms of binding affinity. In fact, producing molecules with binding affinities over 10% higher than the next best model. And similarly, for synthetic accessibility, we found that IDOLpro was one of the top performing models. In particular, we can see that IDOLpro does a really good job of balancing both binding affinity and synthetic accessibility when plotted on two axes. We can see that IDOLpro is near the bottom left corner, showing that it can co-optimize these properties. So on top of comparing IDOLpro with other generative models in the literature, we also wanted to compare it with a classic virtual screening approach for finding good small molecules for a target protein, which, as mentioned before, is the traditional way of completing this task. So what we did was we took 10 disease-related targets. Within these 10 targets, there is the SARS-CoV-2 protease, as well as a number of other relevant disease-related proteins. For each of these targets, we took a database of commercially available compounds, and we docked all of these compounds within this database to each of the 10 targets. The database which we docked is called Zinc-250K and contains 250,000 commercially available compounds. After we docked those molecules to those 10 targets, we wanted to see how long it would take IDOLpro to produce a molecule with both better binding affinity and better synthetic accessibility than anything found in the virtual screen. On average, we found that IDOLpro requires producing less than 50 molecules in order to surpass the performance of all 250,000 molecules considered in the virtual screen. This translates to approximately a 200 times speed up and over a 125 times reduction in cost in order to find a molecule with good desired properties. An additional task that's common in drug discovery is called lead optimization, where rather than generating the entire molecule from scratch, you're going to want to take a scaffold and decorate that scaffold with additional functional groups in order to produce a ligand with better binding affinity to a target protein. Because IDOLpro is trained to generate molecules from scratch, we have to use a special technique in order to apply this sort of conditioning. The technique that we use is called inpainting. In inpainting, you have some set of atoms that you want fixed at the end of your diffusion process. Diffusion will generally run for some fixed amount of steps. Let's call that capital T. When you implement in painting, you take the atoms that you want fixed. This would be at time step zero, because when we run reverse diffusion, we run from time big T to time zero, just because it's reverse. And at time step zero, you want to have the atoms in their fixed position. So what you do is you take those atoms and you noise them. You actually run the forward diffusion process on those atoms and noise them for T steps. Then when we run reverse diffusion, at each step, we replace the model's predictions of those atoms with their noised representation. Therefore, when we finish the reverse diffusion process, those atoms are going to be in exactly the position with the right atom type based on the fixed scaffold. And we're going to get additional atoms that will decorate that molecule in order to produce a novel molecule with, again, optimized properties from the IDOLpro workflow. And yeah, we have some results in our paper analyzing the performance of IDOLpro for a lead optimization task. We take this data set, the cross-dock data set, which contains 100 protein ligand pairs. And we take the scaffolds from each of the ligands and we run lead optimization with IDOLpro. And we find that for all but one target, we're able to produce a new molecule that has both better binding affinity and synthetic accessibility than the seed molecule. So some future directions that we see for IDOLpro is to integrate additional scoring functions. For instance, toxicity, solubility, and other properties that are going to be of interest to medicinal chemists and will help produce ligands that can be synthesized and useful within a lab setting as quickly as possible. To sum up, we've presented this multi-objective generative AI pipeline capable of generating molecules both de novo and with complex conditioning tasks that are both designed for a target protein and co-optimize some set of physicochemical properties. So like on top of just being a research project, we've actually already applied IDOLpro to real drug discovery campaigns. The way we do this is by actually using IDOLpro to perform virtual screening, replacing expensive database iteration. The way we do this is we have some target protein in mind, and we get IDOLpro to generate a bunch of ligands de novo for this protein. Afterwards, we take a large chemical database, much, much larger than we would have been able to analyze were we to compute every single desirable physicochemical property of molecules within that database, and we just search for similar molecules to the ones that are produced by IDOLpro. The nice thing when you search through these large chemical libraries, as opposed to synthesizing something that's coming out of the model directly, is that these molecules will often be immediately purchasable and synthesizable in a lab. And we've actually had success doing this. And again, to reiterate, this is because we're able to search a much larger chemical space when we're comparing molecules than when we are trying to evaluate something like binding affinity for each of these molecules in the database. If you enjoyed this talk and you want to learn more about cool research that's being done at Sandbox, then you can check out our website. We have a full list of our latest publications there, as well as a lot more information about the awesome things that we're doing at Sandbox.